Hi, Graham Vincent, violin maker and musician. I thought I'd do a quick video just to let you know what I'm up to, really, because it's Tuesday, haven't posted anything this week, and there's been plenty going on. But yeah, so what have I been doing? Well, I'm working on, I'm making three ash violins at the moment. The rib garlands are all together, and I'm just starting work on the fronts and the backs. I've actually got to put the linings into the ribs first of all, actually. That's not done yet, but I'm hoping to get the, let's say I'm hoping to get the rib garlands finished today. That's accurate. In addition to that, I'm also making, I just started a couple of other things. I've wanted for a long time to make some guitar-shaped violins, so I've started a couple of those, and I'm hoping to have those ready for Sidmouth. The three ash violins that I'm doing are all sold, and I'm hoping they will all be out of here sort of early July. And then it's going to be a mad sprint to have stuff ready, have stock ready for the Sidmouth Folk Festival. And I've also got another thing which I want to show you. Let me just switch this round. Yeah, this is bog oak. It's an oak tree that grew several thousand, oh, it's not focusing. Go on then. Several thousand years ago and fell over into a bog. And it just, because there's no oxygen in the bog, it just sits there, and you get black bog oak. This is a really dark, rich kind of brown. It's gorgeous, absolutely wonderful. But this piece of timber we're looking at here, which comes from Germany in this particular case, or you get bog oak in the UK and in some other places as well. But this piece of timber is probably sort of 4,000 to 6,000 years old. So, you know, you're talking about, let's get this right, before the pyramids, before Stonehenge. So this is so old. It's hard to comprehend how very old this timber is. And yet it's just like this really fabulous, mature, seasoned piece of oak. A lot of bog oak is absolutely full of splits and shakes, and you have to be a little bit careful. But anyway, yeah, one of a friend of mine, basically, who heard me whittering on about making guitar-shaped violins, said, actually, make me one. So we had a chat about something special, and I'm not going to be doing this one, I don't think, until after the Sidmouth show, but keep your eyes peeled, because you'll probably see this progressing in the background now and then. It's going to have a carved scroll as well. Not a standard scroll, but a carving. But I won't tell you any more. Wait and see. But it's going to be pretty special, I think. And then in addition to that, something I've wanted to talk about for ages is the two Wormy Chestnut fiddles, which I finished and went off to the States. And the customer in the States sent me a video, and it's just a lovely, lovely video of them unboxing it. So I'm going to just put that on now so you can see what they thought of them.
Okay, we are recording. Alrighty. Tune her up and let's put a bow across the strings and see what happens. Fiddle like that.
the viola, as I'm sure you know, is finished and gone, and that's now with the customer, who was really happy with it, and it did fit beautifully with the violin I made for her previously in Pearwood. So I was really happy with that, and I'm pretty sure she was as well. So that's great news. Well, I didn't say, did I? The guitar-shaped violin, the couple of them I'm making, are going to be in Spanish cedar, like that violin I made a while back, which was an absolute favourite of mine. Totally unrelated, I got an old British Seagull two-stroke outboard engine to do up to go on my boat. Anyway, yeah, that's it. Just a quick roundup for me. That's what I'm up to. Just going to go and upload this video, and then I'll be back in the workshop beavering on as ever. So, the garden's looking fabulous at the moment. Can't beat England in June. Love it. Even though it was a bit of a slow start to the summer. So, yeah. There will be another update soon. Keep in touch. Cheers, folks. Look after yourselves.